back, and I'm sure your audience remembers 2016 and the fight that we had. You know, if Donald Trump wins, there's going to be nuclear war, and people are going to die, and it's going to be death and chaos and destruction. And what do we have? We have record low unemployment. We have a booming market. We have just an amazing abundance of opportunity now for all Americans with the amount of jobs that are being created, a 250,000 alone this month. And we see that this has stoked more fear into the elitists, because who was this businessman who didn't have to kiss the ring, who didn't have to suck up to the donors, who didn't need the media, that just said, hey, I want to make the American people just as prosperous as I have been? Well, that's not allowed. So you have someone in President Trump now who's essentially put the lid back on the $20 trillion cookie jar and said, no more. The United States is no longer the piggy bank. We have to take care of all people first. And so the global elites are infuriated right now. And that's why you see there's more talk of doom and gloom and destruction under Trump. But I believe, just as I did in 2016, that the American people see right through it. 70% of Americans know there's fake news out there. They can see exactly what's happening. They're looking at their 401ks. They see the future. Consumer confidence is at an all-time high. Small businesses, I mean, the list can go on. You can go to promiseskept.com. We can't keep track of everything that's happening because the president made a commitment to Americans, and he is doing everything that he can. And I heard you mentioning some of the rallies that he's been doing today, keeping that commitment to help hold the majority in the House and the Senate so we can move forward on the pro-America agenda.
So Gina, how's the president feeling? You had a fun trip this week. Tell us about that.
I did. I got to go for Air Force One with the president. Biggest honor of my whole entire life. I hope that you all get to do that someday.
We can't guarantee that. It's very good of you to come along tonight. We appreciate it, but that is something we can't do.
Boundless energy. The man has such a passion, such a heart for each and every one of you. He really loves this country. He wants to give back to this country what he feels like he's had. And don't forget, this is a man who had the world by the tail. He could be golfing someplace at one of his luxurious clubs. Instead, he chose to sacrifice and take the bullets every single day because of the passion that you have for him, and he understands that. It is not lost on him, and I always want to assure you of that. He has you in his heart and his mind every single day, and he expresses that over and over again when you're with him. I know you all know.
So Sebastian, I mean, the elites, they're sort of dying to get revenge, aren't they? I mean, just to see the look on their faces if they don't succeed.
They've been dying since November 2016.
Right.
Because remember, what did the New York Times or the Huffington Post tell us? On the day of the election, Hillary Clinton has a 94%, 95% lock-in. And the most glorious night of my life is watching that barometer on the New York Times go from 95% to zero, right? I mean, that was, the thing about Donald Trump is he owes the elite nothing. I mean, this is why Brexit occurred. It's this reaction to a failed elite, 40 years of failure and non-representation. That's why he's so dangerous, because the establishment doesn't need him. And the establishment knows that he's going to fix the things that they've created as problems. And the biggest point, Gina said he had this boundless energy. I've seen it. I worked for him in the campaign, worked for him in the White House, 2.5 hours sleep a day, never saw him tired, he never said, guys, I'm taking a nap now. Doesn't happen. Yeah. But the remarkable thing about this man is he wants all Americans to be safe and to prosper, whether or not you voted for him. And that's what the left will never, I mean, their heads will explode before they believe that he actually wants that for everybody.
That's right. I mean, how do you feel about that? That's, I can see a lot of people nodding. Exactly. It's just, and that's why I just get so upset when he, and especially his supporters, are just characterized as these selfish, self-interested, racist, xenophobic, you know, that it's elitist talk. I just find it so offensive on behalf of Trump supporters, who are just decent people who want the best for their family and their community. And they've got a president who's delivering that. Anyway, we've got to go. So sorry, we're out of time. Up next, what could happen if the Democrats take back Congress? Don't go away.